work with that industry. You know, let me come from outside and come and break all the rules and all that. You know. But I kept thinking, these guys are conservative. What if you get, let's say, an MTN business, and MTN says, okay, well, you have to, where is your NIPR certificate? Where is your PRCAN membership? So I thought, okay, why not? I hate exams. I'm not going to do exams. I tried everything possible to try and see if they can bypass it for me. Spoke to the president of PRCAN, had meetings with him. Did the man just fell in love with me? Said, I like you. Go and do exams. He called the registrar of NIPR. That one said, no problem. We'll go and see the agency. They are good. But let him go and do his exams. So everything kept coming back to go and do your exams. So in 2012, I took 8-week course. Sat for the exam, I was sitting in the class. I would be upset with that teacher. Sat for it. I was fortunate I passed. Most of you don't pass that exam once. You may always have to receive one paper. I passed. Last year we were inducted into PRCAN. Now let's say we were inducted in February or March. First, you do your NIPR stuff and then it takes time. Then NIPR is like ICANN. It's like the professional body for PRCAN. For PRCAN is the umbrella body for PR agencies in Nigeria. Let's say we did that. 2-3 months later, I got an invitation to come and speak, to come and train at a PRCAN workshop. You need to understand what that means. I've only been an NIPR member for just a few months. I've only been a PRCAN member for just a few months. So that opportunity would never have come if I did not do that, right? Okay, so I go to speak at this PRCAN event just a few months ago, and there's a gentleman called YPU, your manager, Okusonya, who is one of the leading PR consultants in Nigeria. I'll meet him there the first time. I meet him, of course, he wasn't joining. So I give my paper, he was on digital PR. And by the time I was leaving that day, the man that offered the ILE, you have to go and speak in Mauritius, Rabbi, the PR industry. Continental, it's called APRA, as you know, public relations agencies in Africa, we have to go and speak. I'm off to Mauritius tomorrow to go and speak to the entire continent. Just because of what? I understood the value of what? Getting chartered and doing that. I would never have done it. I don't want to do it. Guess what? We did not plan. It was not part of our plan. Just like my guy who said he was going to make $150 million. There was no way we were going to work for a multinational in 2013. He was not in our schedule. We didn't know them. We didn't lobby for it. But in February 2013, we had one partnership with the Nigerian Breweries, one of their brands, Star. We launched the project and they liked our work. And all through 2013, I cannot count the amount of business we did for the Nigerian Breweries, from Gouda to Star, to Amsterdam Water, to Pharaoh's, name it. He was not in the plan. I can assure you that now, when you get a new business like that, issues will come up. I can assure you that one of the issues would have been, but these guys are quacks now. Go and check now. They're not part of PRCAN. This guy is not even another PRCAN. So when petitions fly left, right, and center, they will hold on to it. Now, in goal setting, we're good at BHL. We're doing well. We work for Viacom. We work for Moyet, work on a lot of portfolios and Nigerian Breweries and a lot of other clients. Like I said earlier, I can rest and say, oh boy, finally we have arrived. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And say, we made good money.
Good money, that's true.
But if you remember the name Black House, that where we got it from. Okay, I'm like, okay, now we have an opportunity to actually begin to establish the path towards this big dream that we have. So, at the point when I should be spending my money and living large and sleeping in hotels and doing all that, I begin the books, the studying I hated, the exams I hated, I begin to go for conferences. And it's on one of those trips that we're like, okay, what is the future of PR? It's digital. why not start a digital agency? That's what brought about ID Africa. In the whole of Nigeria today, I don't think we are up to 10 digital agencies. If you have interest in PR or marketing or advertising, please go and study digital marketing and do it. There are huge opportunities there, very huge. And it's like a surface that has not been touched at all. So as I speak to you, BHM is about 7 years old. We have not shared dividend once. Not once, director. I have not earned a salary this year. They paid me in, I think, early this year, all the money from last year. I borrowed the company back. So I can afford to buy a new car for myself, my dream car. I can afford to take my family on holidays. But it's not time because, okay, yes, we're making this money, but where did we say we are going to? This is where we are going to. This is the point where you begin to claw this thing back. So I started in Africa. And the story of BHM is the story of NET. I've shared the story of NET with you. He mentioned about the conference earlier. Last year, we started this conference also. And it's in line with what we want NET to do. We want NET to be number one. New York Times, see the name, New York Times. It was a newspaper created, I mean, for the New York region. He's an American newspaper. He's read all over the world. Yes. New York Times has published more authoritative articles on Boko Haram and Chibok than any African newspaper of continent. New York Times, Los Angeles Times,
Washington Post.
The Washington Post, Wall Street Journal. Wall Street Journal. So who says you cannot have a Nigerian entertainment today that will be global in relevance? Today, we cover Kenya, we cover Ghana, we cover Israel, we cover Nigeria. And if you check in Kenya ranking, they will rank us in Kenya, they will rank us in Ghana. Who says? You might try and fail, and it's fine. But it won't be said that we did not try. So if we can read New York Times in Nigeria, I read the Wild Times and the Guardian UK almost every day. These are newspapers made for British and American people. Why are we then here? So, and it's part of that vision that we say, okay, create a conference and actually bring everyone together and begin to set an agenda for the future. Now, human capital, I'm happy that the next person is speaking on HR and recruiting and all that. Human capital management is a big issue for businessmen. Big issue. How do you find the right people? How do you keep them? How do you keep being creative with your business ideas while you are under the pressure of managing people and resources? Now, my wife is a HR consultant. So I'm like, no, don't work at the HR. Don't do that. Don't get a job anymore. Set up a consultancy. You love this thing, you know it. That's everyone's. It started the way AY, ENI started. Recruited for companies within entertainment. Now, you won't believe how wide it is. The kind of briefs that they get. Oh no, we're trying to do this whole thing. So it's what I did is start at the lowest level possible. The lowest level possible. I had nothing to lose. I keep saying it. Each time I advise my friends who have good jobs to leave their matter their own business, they will tell me that if they have nothing to lose. When I left the economy, if you remember, I was earning just 10,000 naira. So when you tell a man that is earning a million naira a month to leave the job, he will look in the face and say, well, you're wicked. So I started at the point where there was nothing to do. And where I did not even have full identity. This was me here, this must have been by the time I left in Comion and moved to London, I was a shirt and jeans guy, regular guy, and all that. This is me in April this year. Now this is all that's in my wardrobe. This is me. This is essential me today. So it's a process. You start at the point where even your vision for the business, the way you run it, will mature and grow over the years. I'll round up in a few minutes. Having said all that, I'll give you guys the bad news. And I'm using myself as case study because I think that's the way it can be more impactful. was speaking with an old friend 2 days ago, and I said to her, she runs a consultancy. She has just three staff. Two of them work from her client services, one works from her office. She's okay, she closes at 4-5, goes to her, and I'm like, babe, that was my dream a few years ago. My dream was to have a life that I can close at 4-5 and go play with my kids, take my wife out, go and see a movie, and do other read books I'd love to read. I haven't read one book from back to back, I think since 2000, since maybe very early last year. There's no time. So I said to her, well, the bad news is that you will find it difficult, almost impossible, God help me, to get a work-life balance. And we must all work to make sure that the businesses that we try to build does not now rob us of the life that we need to live. What's the point of building an Apple, or a Twitter, or a Facebook, or a GT Bank, or a First Bank, if you are going to die because you did not manage your all-star work, or you will ruin your eyes over 20 years of exposure, you damage your health, or you damage your relationship with your parents, with your siblings, with your children, with your wife. Many of us are not involved in our children's upbringing. I personally am not. My kids are off to bed by the time I get home. Next morning, they're trying to play and rushing out to work, or they're rushing out to school. Weekends, I'm out. You travel for a week, 10 days. That's a major bad news for me. Because at the end of the day, what's the point? If you make all the money, if you make all the big things, trust me, there is no point. The real joy of life is with family, and money cannot buy.
That's right.
That's a bad news. And that bad news is that Nigeria, this Nigeria will frustrate you. Trust me. And I mean everything from Nigeria. The people you will employ, the roads you will ply, the equipment you will buy, your landlord. Just think of everything, it will frustrate you. Everything will. At the point you will almost feel, man, I can't do this. But guess what? You can. Then you will make disappointments at every point in time. I'm still borrowing money. I think you want money to borrow this week. I'll call my friend. Why? Well, I need to plan 5 million. People will go with your money. I see threatening a client this week. You see phone over SMS, pay me my money. You will owe people. Some people tell you, I can't do this, or you are still owing me 4 million, 5 million. It's difficult. But you know the worst bad news, which I didn't tell you guys earlier when I was saying what I did. You will recall failures. I failed several times. Apart from the events I told you guys I did that people didn't come, I've done projects that have failed, that you'll be practically ashamed of yourself. You will recall failures. But as I said, if we're young, and I'm trying to assume they are reading, if you're young and you start, you start again. I can take a walk this moment from BHM, leave everything, just give me my Mac, just give me my computer, and I'll move to Kaduna or to Kano or to Abuja or to